What if I told you that you could turn a tiny chip from the 1970s into a magical music box? That's right. No fancy microcontrollers, no programming. Just a humble 555 timer and a few basic components. Hey guys! In this video, I'll show you how to build a simple but mesmerizing music box that plays real tones using one of the most legendary ICs in electronics. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 555 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 2 alligator clips, 17 jumper wires, 2 33,000 ohm resistors, 2 22,000 ohm resistors, 3 15,000 ohm resistors, 3 10,000 ohm resistors, 8 1N4148 fast switching diodes, 2 555 timer ICs, 1 CD4017 decade counter, 1 5-watt speaker, a battery holder with 4 AA batteries for the power source, 2 10 microfarad capacitors, 1 10 nanofarad ceramic capacitor, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Starting from the top left is pin 1, which is ground or the ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and a stable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, a stable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Start by placing the 555 timer IC onto the breadboard. Remember, the pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 33 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 33 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3 or output and pin 6 or threshold. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger and the negative rail. The anode is in pin 2. Place the CD4017 decade counter in the middle of the breadboard, a few rows beneath the 555 timer. Make sure it straddles the middle gap so each pin has its row for easy wiring. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 of the 555 and pin 14 of the 4017. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 16 and the positive rail. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 and pin 13. Insert a jumper wire into pin 13 and pin 15. Place a 5-5-5 timer into the lower half of the breadboard, making sure it straddles the center gap with its pins on both sides. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 33 kilo ohm resistor. Similar to the first 555, insert the 33 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3 or output and pin 6 or threshold. Insert a 10 nanofarad ceramic capacitor into pin 2 or trigger and the negative rail. Bend the ends of a 1N4148 fast switching diode. Insert a 1N4148 fast switching diode into pin 4 and a few rows below the CD4017. Bend the ends of a 10 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 10 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the diode and a few rows above the second 555 timer. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the resistor and pin 5 or control. Insert a diode into pin 6 and a few rows below the 4017. Bend the ends of the diode. Bend the ends of a 22 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 22 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the diode and in the same row as the previous resistor. Insert a diode into pin 2 and a few rows below the 4017. Bend the ends of the diode. Bend the ends of a 15 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 15 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the previous diode and in the same row as the previous resistor. Insert a diode into pin 3 and a few rows below the 4017. Insert the 10 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the previous diode and in the same row as the previous resistor. Insert a diode into pin 10 and a few rows below the 4017. Insert the 22 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the previous diode and in the same row as the previous resistor. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the resistor in pin 5 of the second 555. Insert a diode into pin 9 and a few rows below the 4017. Insert the 10 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the previous diode and in the same row as the previous resistor. Insert a diode into pin 11 and a few rows below the 4017. Insert the 15 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the previous diode and in the same row as the previous resistor. Insert a diode into pin 1 and a few rows below the 4017. Be sure to insert it on the right side of the breadboard as the left side no longer has available space. Insert the 15 kilo ohm resistor in the same row as the previous diode and in the same row as the previous resistor. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor into pin 3 or output, and a few rows below the second 555. The anode is in pin 3. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the capacitor. Attach the other end of the jumper wire to the alligator clip. Insert a jumper wire in the negative rail. Attach the other end of the jumper wire to the alligator clip. Attach the other ends of the alligator clips to the 5-watt speaker. It's time to connect the power supply. Connect the positive lead of the battery holder to the positive rail. Connect the negative lead of the battery holder to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. Picture this circuit as two tiny musicians, the 555 timers and one conductor, the CD4017 counter, all running from the same 6-volt battery rail. The first 555 is wired as a slow stable oscillator with a 33 kilo ohm resistor and a 10 microfarad capacitor. That combo charges and discharges about once every 0.65 seconds, so pin 3 flips high-low, roughly 1.5 times per second. Every rising edge is sent straight to the CD4017's CLK or pin 14, giving the counter its steady beat, the metronome that decides how long each note lasts. Inside the 4017, only one of its 10 outputs, Q0 to Q9, is high at a time. Each clock pulse marches that high along the row of outputs. 8 of those lines, Q0 to Q9, are used. Q3 and Q6 are left open to create natural rests in the melody. Every active output feeds through its 1N4148 diode into a dedicated resistor, 10 kilo ohm resistor, 15 kilo ohm resistor, or 22 kilo ohm resistor. The diodes keep the lines from fighting each other, and the resistors form a simple resistor ladder that sets the control voltage for the next stage. The second 555 is another stable oscillator, this time much faster, Its base frequency is set by a fixed 33 kilo ohm resistor and a 10 nanofarad capacitor. Here's the trick. All those resistors from the 4017 converge on pin 5 of this 555. Pin 5 is the control voltage input that defines the internal 1/3 VCC and 2/3 VCC switching thresholds. When a 4017 output goes high, its resistor nudges pin 5 up or down, shifting the thresholds. That directly stretches or shrinks the charge discharge time of the 10 nanofarad capacitor, so the oscillator's frequency jumps to a new, precise pitch. The audio signal leaves pin 3 of the right-hand 555, passes through a 10 microfarad coupling capacitor, blocking DC, and drives the 5-watt speaker. As soon as the 4017 counts past Q9 or pin 11, its carryout line feeds back to its reset pin, forcing the sequence to restart from Q0 or pin 3. The melody therefore loops indefinitely while the first 555 keeps time. I hope this video has shown you how to make a music box with 555 timer ICs. Want to dive deeper into 555 timer projects? Grab my free ebook packed with awesome circuits and ideas. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.